skillet, spring chicken dinner. So we have bone and skin on chicken. I'm just browning this on all sides until the skin gets nice and crispy, like this, okay? And it gets almost there, but not quite. Let me go backwards and show you what we did to the chicken. So you start the chicken in a large shallow dish or a giant 2.5 gallon plastic bag. The chicken is seasoned with salt and pepper. So now we're going to dress it with the zest of both a lemon and an orange. A beautifully sliced garlic, our sliced garlic. A couple tablespoons of fresh oregano. And we have a little bit of olive oil. So now we're going to add a little red pepper flake, or this is pepperoncini. It's ground a little finer. Same diff. And then you throw it in the fridge for 30 minutes to 1 hour. I have big fat spring onions here, but baby leeks or leeks, period, are delicious in this dish. And I have about 12 ounces or 3 fat handfuls of snap peas and 1 large or 2 small to medium sized bundles, a little over a pound, 1.25 pounds to 1.5 pounds of asparagus, because we're going to trim the asparagus. So we hold it at both ends, and where the asparagus naturally breaks is how we cut off all those ends. To the rest of it, I'm gonna cut in a large bias, big, pretty chunks, a little bit bigger than bite size. We ground our chicken first, and in the drippings of the chicken, we're literally kind of dry frying or charring our vegetables in very little oil. We wanna keep them tender crisp with some green color, but literally browned or charred edges. So as soon as they start to slump up like this, we're going to add 3 tablespoons of vinegar to your giant skillet, and then we're going to emulsify the vinegar and create a little pan sauce by melting in 3 tabs of butter. We're stirring that in. We're gonna add about a cup of bone broth or stock, picking up all that good stuff. We're gonna let this bubble and simmer away, and the chicken will finish cooking through. Now we're going to finish the dish by adding, from the zested orange, the juice of 1/2 orange, and the juice of the entire lemon, squeezing cut side up to keep the seeds with the lemon instead of in the pan. And now we're going to garnish with lots of mint and parsley. And then we're going to add feta cheese, or you could do ricotta salata, also delicious. And what's great about these giant skillet suppers is that you just serve them right from the pan.